If you've been looking for ways to make your app more beautiful, then you probably know about animations, and you probably already know about Lottie animations. Now, what that has to do with .NET MAUI and why my arm is going like this, you'll find out in this video. So Lottie is the name of a technique that is basically an alternative to GIFs and other kinds of animated images. It is supposed to be lightweight. It's based on JSON. You can do it with Adobe After Effects. I think you can create the animations there. I'm not a graphical person myself, so I have no clue how to get started with that, but I know how to add them to my .NET MAUI application and make my apps more beautiful. And that's what I'm going to learn you in this video as well, so you can make beautiful .NET MAUI applications. Lottie animations have been available in Xamarin and Xamarin Forms before with a nice plugin, but you know, now that we're transitioning into .NET MAUI, we see a lot of libraries who are going to make the transition now. And also, you know, there are libraries who are not maintained anymore. So, you know, it might be that some of those libraries have to be picked up by others or will be included in libraries that already exist and suddenly now start taking in, you know, this functionality. And I think the same is true for like these Lottie animations as well. We already have SkiaSharp, with which you can draw amazing things super, super fast. And now as part of SkiaSharp, you can also do Lottie animations in your .NET MAUI application. Let's just check out how to do that. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022, the preview at the time of recording we still need for a .NET MAUI application. By the time you're watching this, you might be able to use the stable version of Visual Studio. And here I have a .NET MAUI. It's just a file new .NET MAUI application, a project that I started. You can see it running here for Windows. And of course, everything that I'm going to show you also works for iOS, Android, Windows, macOS. You can run it on all those targets. Now, this is a nice template. And as all new templates, there is some button that increments a counter that is supposed to be there for a new template. I don't know why, but we also, it's kind of static, right? So how cool would it be if we could give that little .NET bot a little upgrade? So that's exactly what we're going to do. Now, let's stop running here for a second. And the first thing that I want to do is bring in the SkiaSharp NuGet package, basically. So I'm going to right click on the project right here, and I'm going to say manage NuGet packages. Also at the time of recording, this is a pre-release, so be sure to check that include pre-release check right here. And then I'm going to search for SkiaSharp. You can already see it pop up, extended.ui.maui. So it's also available for forms. I think it's also available for a bunch of other platforms. So if that's what you need, also go check that out. But I'm interested in .NET MAUI for now. So click this. I'm going to install that on my project. And because it's a single project, it's automatically going to install this for iOS, Windows, Android, macOS, all these things. So it's going to bring in a couple of dependencies. And I accept all the license agreements here. And then, boom, it installed it on my project. And I can start working with SkiaSharp and all the other controls in here. So you have to be sure this is the extended.ui, because the base SkiaSharp library does, you know, provide you with all the drawing APIs, but this is specifically for the Lottie animation. If you want to know more about SkiaSharp, please let me know down in the comments and I'll be sure to make more videos on that. So we got that in place. Now, another thing that we need to do is go into our MAUI program.cs and we need to bootstrap our little SkiaSharp thing here. So in our builder, we have use.NET MAUI app, and I'm also going to say dot use SkiaSharp. You can already see that IntelliSense is helping me here, and it adds the right using here at the top. If not, make sure to include this one. And now we are in place. Everything is bootstrapped. Whenever we start running this, our builder knows to include all the things for SkiaSharp, and we are ready to use the SkiaSharp library. If you don't do this, you will get a runtime exception. So be sure to get this in there. Now, what we can do is go to our main page, and what I'm going to do is replace this image with a SkiaSharp thing. So to actually do that, we need to have a little shorthand for our Skia library, right? Another XML namespace. So let's add that here, XML NS. I'm going to name that Skia. That name can be anything you want. And just search here in the IntelliSense for SkiaSharp. Now there's a couple popping up. You want to have the Skia extended UI.controls. So that's the one you want. It will add a little blurb of text here. But now we can replace this image with Skia colon, and we can see a Lottie view. We also have a confetti view, which is very cool as well. And we have a couple of other things here. So if you want to know more about the confetti view, I personally do. So please make me look into that by leaving a comment saying that you want to know more. But we're interested in the Lottie view. Now, the Lottie view also has a source. I'll come back to that in a little bit. There are a couple of things that are important here. So we need to set a height and a width request. So I'm also going to set the width request right now also to 200 because Lottie can use scalable graphics. So it's just an SVG basically inside of this JSON file. So it can scale to infinity, which is really cool. But you have to set a width and a height request, else it won't know how big it has to render here. So we need to set that. The source is of importance. So we'll get to that in a little bit. And there are some other things here. So look for animation, basically. We have events for animation failed, animation loaded. So you have events that will know whenever something's up, something happened with your animation, or your animation has loaded and you can trigger a little piece of code if that's what you want. Is animation enabled? So that says, like, is the animation running currently? Yes or no? You can kind of like pause and unpause your animation. But also we have some things with repeat. So we have a repeat count. If we set that to 10, the animation in the file is going to repeat 10 times and then it's going to be done. You can also set it to 0, then it's going to never repeat. So it's only going to play once. That's kind of like a shift in mindset, right? Or you can set it to -1 and then it will repeat until infinity. Now we also saw a repeat mode and we have two. So we have a restart. So basically whenever the animation is done, it will wind back to the beginning without showing anything and then restart from there. Or we have the reverse. So it will play linear to the end and then it will go back basically through all the frames. So you see the exact but then reverse, and that can make for more fluent animation. So you can play with that. I'm going to leave it at the default, which I'm not even sure what the default is, but it works for me. So let's bring in our animation now, and that's really cool. We can go to the resources and the raw folder right here. So we have things for app icon, fonts, images, but this is going to be a raw resource, right? Because this is a JSON file and that needs to be accessed by the platforms. It's not something that we can recognize from our .NET MAUI single project. So it has to be a raw resource. And with this raw resource, we can just, you know, plug it in there and we can reach out to it through through anything, basically through our code. So let's right click add existing item. And on my desktop, there should be, oh, it's filtered on files. So let's do all files. I have .netbot.json. Well, what might that be? What might that be? I don't know. So let's add that. And then I can update the source here simply to say .netbot.json and save that. And boom, we're ready to actually show this puppy. So let's run this on my Windows machine. I'm going to run it right here. And we should now, you know, it's going to build all the things, bring in that SkiaSharp code. We're going to bootstrap that through our MAUI program. We've hooked in to that SkiaSharp little thingy. I added the .netbot.json. And whenever our screen is now coming up, then our .netbot is not going to be really static anymore, but it's actually going to be, you know, as this description right here, a cute .NET bot waving hi at you. So let's see that. Here we are. We have this little .NET bot, which is actually waving to you. So how cool is that? This is all that is needed to add very cool animations, Lottie animations, to your .NET MAUI application. Now, there are a couple of things to note here. First, SkiaSharp, you know, it brings in a dependency. It is a relatively large one. So if that's something that you do not want, you're going to have to wait until another library is going to implement this, which is maybe a little bit more lightweight. But on the other hand, you know, it's going to bring in a lot of goodies. And with all the new build processes and compiler and linking and trimming, it will shake out. It's called tree shaking. It will shake out all the APIs that are not needed during, you know, a release build. So all those APIs are going to fall off and your app shouldn't grow by that much, actually. But that's something for you to try and decide if that's something that you're willing to take on. The other thing, while implementing this, I said already, I'm not a graphical person. I cannot create these type of animations. So I went out to Fiverr to someone to do this for me. I'm very thankful for that. Thank you so much for doing this to create a wonderful video. But the first version that I got had incorporated like base 64 encoded PNGs. And that didn't work with this plugin. So be really sure that if you go inside of that JSON source, if you see like a PNG image slash PNG and then some base 64, you will know it when you see it. It's kind of like those data URL things that you can also use on HTML. Whenever that's in there, it won't work at the time of recording, at least with the SkiaSharp plugin. I already mentioned it as a bug. I raised the issue and it's is going to be worked on, but you want to have like pure JSON animations, and that will actually work as we've seen here in this video. Now, if you want to know more about .NET MAUI, make sure to check out this playlist, and here is a very recommended video, especially for you. Be sure to click this button so that you're subscribed, like this video, and I'll see you for the next one.